Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to display information about X and Y axis values of a chart with horizontal and vertical lines using the crosshair feature. I will also show you how to easily track and display information about the data points closest to the pointer position using the trackball feature. Now, let me show you how to write the code to add a crosshair and trackball to Vue Charts. I open an existing Vue application, where I have already added the Vue Charts component with basic properties. I had defined a line series charts and bound a sales data source to it. I have imported the chart plugin from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Charts package and registered it globally inside the API vue.use to register all child directives globally. Also, I have imported the line series module from same package and injected it in the provide option. If you would like to know how to create a Vue app and add Syncfusion components to it, click the video link in the card above. You can also find a reference link in the description below. I save the application and run it with the command npm run serve. Here, you can see the Vue line chart with sales data. Next, I will show how to add a crosshair to the chart. But before we move on, let us look at this example. The line chart shows a large number of data points that illustrate sales data. If you like to see the data better, you can enable horizontal and vertical crosshairs and a crosshair tooltip to view the values of both the X and Y axes based on the mouse pointer position in the chart area. To add the crosshair to the chart, first, I import the crosshair module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Charts package and inject it in the provide option. Second, I define the variable chart crosshair and enable the crosshair by defining the enable property as true. Also, I need to enable crosshair tooltips for both axes to display corresponding X and Y values. So, within the chart primary X and Y axis variables, let me define the crosshair tooltip property and set the enable property to true. Along with this, I will set the edge label placement property to shift to move edge axis label inside the chart area. Now, I assign this variable to the crosshair property. As you can see, the chart output shows vertical and horizontal crosshair lines with the axis values of the chart, and the axis label is placed inside the chart area. Next, I will show you how to customize crosshair lines and tooltips using the fill and text style properties. Using the fill property, you can customize the background color of the crosshair. And using the text style property, you can customize the font style of the text displayed on the crosshair tooltips. I am planning to add a background color to the crosshair tooltip, so let me define the fill property and set a color code as the value. In addition to this, I am going to change the font size and font color for the tooltip, so I define the text style property and add a size and color to it. Look at the chart output now. You can see the crosshair tooltips have a different background color, font size, and font color. Next, I will show how to change the line type. By default, crosshairs display both horizontal and vertical lines. If you want to show a vertical line alone, define the line type property and set its value to vertical within this chart crosshair variable. Also, I will remove the y-axis crosshair tooltip as I am going to show only the vertical crosshair line. When you look at the chart output now, only a vertical crosshair line is shown. Finally, I am going to show you how to enable the trackball in Vue Charts to easily track the nearest data points to the mouse pointer hover position. Let's first see a simple example of the trackball feature. This line chart shows the sales information about three people. If I want to track or compare the sales values for each person, I use this trackball marker to clearly see the closest data point and display its information in a tooltip. To enable the trackball, first, I need to modify the existing data source by adding two more fields, sales1 and sales2, and assign values to them. Then, I define two more E-series tags and set the series type as line. Now, I bind data source properties and map their data source fields to these chart series. In the chart tooltips, I am going to display data point information clearly, so I will define the property name and set series values to it. To add the trackball feature, I need to enable the chart tooltip and shared option. So, first, I import the tooltip module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Charts package and inject it in the Provide option. Then, I define the variable chart tooltip and add enable and shared properties with the value true. Also, I am planning to format the tooltip, so I will add the format property and assign a value like this. Along with this, make sure that the crosshair is enabled and that the line type is vertical. Finally, I assign this variable to the tooltip property. You can see the line series chart showing sales information about 3 different people with the trackball feature enabled. Okay, let's quickly recap what we learned. We saw how to add crosshairs and trackballs to Syncfusion Vue Charts. We also discussed how to enable and customize a crosshair tooltip. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Vue component suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.